Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today we're going to deploy an Axum API to fly.io. Axum is pretty sweet. I've been working with it for a little while now, but today we're not really here to talk about what Axum is so much as get it deployed. So let's pick one of these to deploy today. And since this is the first one we've ever deployed on this channel, let's go with the nice hello world here. So in main.rs, we've got some code. We'll just copy this in. And we'll explain this in a second. So I'm going to start this off with a cargo new. I'm going to name it Axum Fly Example, and this will create a new binary application for us. I'm going to open VS Code and dump the code that we had from the example right in here. Now we can already see there's going to be a couple of crates that we're going to need. Axum is the obvious one. Tokyo is another one because Axum is built on top of Tokyo. But of the numerous examples in the Axum repo, which are wonderful, I highly encourage you to go see them. Go check them out. There's going to be a cargo TAML. In this case, it's Axum and Tokyo, and Tokyo is going to have features full. So we'll do cargo add Axum Tokyo F Tokyo full. And if I got the syntax right, this will add in both of our dependencies. And we can see the cargo add got added to cargo. So we can see the features that we have here. In this case, we've specified full for Tokyo. And we get a number of things like JSON and query strings and stuff like that for Axum. So we can build that to make sure all our dependencies are downloaded. And on the left-hand side here, we can go over the code now. I'm going to get rid of this Chrome window, and I'll make this a little bit bigger for us. So you can see the example says CD examples and cargo run P example hello world. We don't need this. It doesn't. It's not relevant for our purposes anymore. In our case, we've got the Tokyo main attribute macro, which is taking this async function because we can't write an async main function in Rust. It's taking this async main function and rewriting it to a synchronous main function and wrapping the Tokyo runtime initialization logic around it. Then we've got a router, which comes from Axum. We create the new router and specify a single route that is a get handler. So at the root route, we handle gets with this function down here. This function down here returns us a static string, which is just going to be some HTML. In this case, it's going to be hello world wrapped in H1 tags. Now we'll talk about HTML and JSON and arguments and things like that in future videos. So I'm going to leave that for now. We take this router, which is defined as our app, and we specify a socket address to listen on. In this case, we're listening on 127.0.0.1 port 3000. And we print line out. We're not using tracing or anything fancy like that. We're just using the normal print line macro. And then we bind the address. We call app.intomakeService. We await that. We unwrap it in case anything goes wrong. And that's our entire application. So we can cargo run this. And then I'll open up another terminal below it. And I will, let's do curl. Yeah. Curl 127.0.0.1.3000. And we get hello world. Super simple, super easy. Nothing too fancy here. But what I want to do is I want to launch a new Fly application. So if you've got the Fly CLI installed and you're logged in already, then you can use Fly launch with a name to initialize a new application. Now this is going to let us pick a region. In this case, I'll use San Jose because I don't know, it's close to me. Usually I'd use like US East 1 or something like that because that's where Netlify functions run, and that's where a lot of my like DynamoDBs and things like that are located. But you can see that we've created the app Axum Hello World in my fly.io organization with a config file left in this directory. If we look at the config file, we see a number of things such as the kill signal, the timeout for the kill, the app name, some environment variables. We don't have any set. We can run additional processes. Not going to cover that today. There's some experimental that we are now also not going to cover today. We need to change this internal port because we are running on port 3000, right? So if we look back at this socket, we're running on localhost 3000. So we really have two options. I think that they suggest that you do 8080. So let's do 8080 and then let's leave this as 8080. The only thing here is that those two numbers need to match up. Now we've got concurrency limits. I'm not even going to worry about that. We don't have any state here. And plus I'm going to kill it later after this video. So not too worried about it. In this case, we have a number of ports. So the internal port here, 8080, is going to receive traffic from these two. The networking on fly.io is kind of separate. So we can specify incoming ports, and then we can also specify what service our service is kind of running on. And those things don't need to be like directly connected. We're not binding 80 to 8080. We're saying we accept traffic on these two ports and our service is running on this one. So one huge note here is that if you do set up port 443, you do need TLS and HTTP for this to work, especially if you're forcing HTTPS here. And then there's some TCP checks to make sure that, like, you know, the service is running appropriately. And that's about it. So I think with all of that, if we do fly status, we should see nothing. App has not been deployed yet. And we'll do fly deploy. App does not have a Dockerfile or build packs configured. Ah, right. So I'm going to write a Dockerfile here. And then let's bring back the web browser so I can show this. We're going to go to the Docker Hub. So here's the official image for Rust. And let's do, 1621 Buster. We can't actually select this because it's, there we go. So we'll do in our Dockerfile from this. And then I'm going to add, or I could copy this in too. Let's copy .slash target release. What did we call this? Axum fly example. Fly example. And then I'm going to put that in /opt/axum/fly example. And we're going to have a run of /opt/axum/fly example. And I think that should do it. So cargo run, or not run, let's do cargo build release. We don't really need it to be any particular target. We just need to have the production build here ready for this Dockerfile to pick up. Then we can do a fly deploy. It'll pick up the Dockerfile for us. We don't need to specify that. It's one of those things that is kind of like, if you have a Dockerfile in the repo, then it'll pick it up. If it's not named Dockerfile, then you will have to, you know, figure that out. Now, it can be useful to just set up this whole set of code as a workspace to get the target out of the Docker context. You can see that the Docker context, you can see that I misnamed the Docker image that we're using. We're using Rustlang Rust with a tag of 161 or 1621 Buster. So the Docker build actually failed because I used the wrong name. Huzzah. But you can see that the context that we're sending to the Docker daemon here is actually going to be this entire directory by default. So we have two options there. We can use either a Docker ignore to not send target, or we can use something like a cargo workspace. And then if we put our packages in sort of the root and we move down our fly.io app, then the target will be above and it gets a little bit more messy. So probably just use the Docker ignore file, but be aware that that is a thing. I forgot that we were using an official image, so we don't actually have to do it with Rustlang at the front either, because that would have been the user. So since we're using the Rust official image, it's just going to be named Rust, and we're using a tag of 1621-Buster. Wow, I messed that up twice already. Dang. But you can see that I chose to not do actual any building in my Dockerfile. We could do a multi-stage build. We could do the Rust build inside of the first stage and then copy the binary out into the second stage. But I just rather not do that. We don't really need to do a full build inside of the Dockerfile. Now, because we're not doing a full build inside of the Dockerfile, we are getting this exec format error. So opt axum fly example is not the right format, which means that we do need to actually do our build with a specific target. So we'll do x86. You can see it actually filling in right there for me. x86 unknown Linux GNU. And if you run into this like linker error, especially if you're on an M1 or something like that, you can easily fix that by using cargo zig build. It's kind of funny to use zig's linker instead of, you know, whatever in Clang, but I found cargo zig build to be much more dependable, especially when doing cross compilation, especially from a Mac specifically. So if we ls target, we can see that we have a directory in here, x86 64 unknown Linux GNU, and I'm just gonna slap that in right there so that we get target this. We have release inside of there, and now we can deploy again. Note that up until this point, we haven't had a successful deploy, but we have fixed a couple of errors that can pop up, especially if you're unfamiliar with Docker. Now you'll see the next issue that we ran into, if we use run here, it will actually run our server. So what we want here isn't actually run, it's entry point. Run will let us run something inside of the Docker file, while entry point defines what binary is going to run when we start actually doing a Docker run of our Docker file in production. And you can see that this all built correctly, and now we're pushing it up to the fly registry so that it can be used as the basis for our service running in production. The image size here is 1.3 gigs, which is really big. So we could use like Buster Slim or something like that instead. In this case, I've chosen to use the Buster image just because it will be easiest for us at the moment. And fly.io will create a new release for us. It'll give us a little version number. So in this case, V2, and then it'll monitor our deployment and see if we get a healthy, service out of it. Now, it looks like we have one critical. So we're running one health check here, and one of them is not working. So if we do fly status, we can see our Axum Hello World application. It's in my personal account, and here's the host name. So we can try to hit that if we want to. I'll copy that for a second. And then there's a deployment status, what version we're running. We've placed one successfully. So we asked for one, we placed one. None of them are healthy, but it does list as running, even though the health check is not quite doing what we want it to. So if I copy and paste the host name correctly, what is going on there? Okay, so we can try to curl this. We didn't get back what we thought we should get back. So if we do this with dash V, we can see a little bit more connected, couple of headers, mark bundles, not supporting multi-use, doesn't matter, 301 moved permanently. So we set in our configuration that we should forge each that we should force HTTPS, and that is something that is currently happening. So we can do this to HTTPS instead. And I know that you won't be able to see the amount of time this has taken, but it is kind of just hanging there. It's kind of just like, okay, we've sent the curl request, but we're not getting a response. So what's going on? Well, one reason could be, I'm going to kill this deployment here. One reason could be because we're listening to localhost here. So fly.io does two things that are really interesting. Fly.io lets you allocate IP addresses, so IPv4 addresses, but all of its internal networking is done through IPv6. So instead of using socket address from 127.0.0.0.1, whatever, we're going to do it with this kind of like special syntax. So this will listen on port 8000. We need 8080 here, actually. This will listen on port 8080. For IPv6 and IPv4. So whichever one we're hitting it on. So let's do our build. Let's try to deploy again. So we can see that now with the proper socket address, which is extremely important here, as we can see, we've got V1 deployed successfully. Our health check is now passing. And if we curl our domain, we get hello world wrapped in H1 tags. So I hope this helped you understand how to get a Rust application wrapped up in a very simple, not very complicated Docker file into a Docker image and deployed to fly.io on the correct port, on the correct socket address, so that you can actually see the API come back. And we'll get into more Axum in the future. It's a framework that I really, really like. I think there's a lot that we can talk about here. So if you have any questions about Axum, leave them in the comments. I'll leave a link to the examples that we just looked at in Axum. I'll leave a link to fly.io because we didn't even look at the website, all in the description. And I will catch you in the next video.